H64. Hello everybody, I am NicoD. Today I'm back with another new single board computer. It's the Pine H64 Model B. So this is the second model of the Pine H64. The first model was a lot bigger. It had a PCI Express port, but on the Allwinner H6 SoC, the PCI Express is faulty. So they removed it and they made it the same footprint as a Rock64 or the same as the Raspberry Pi. So this has got a few advantages compared to the Orange Pi3. It's got a smaller footprint. It has got a Raspberry Pi compatible GPIO. This has got a smaller GPIO header. This has got better heat characteristics than this. It's just a few degrees difference, but the few degrees make a big difference at the end. This only has got 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, while this has got 5 GHz Wi-Fi. So the Wi-Fi here is a lot better. That is one thing I miss in this model also. But I'm glad it has got Wi-Fi on board. There are also a few problems with the Allwinner H6 SoC. Like the HDMI sound doesn't work. So it also doesn't work on the H2, H3, H5 and now on the H6. They are not busy with fixing this. The 3.5 mm audio jack, this could work in the future, but it doesn't work yet. Also, the USB 3 works at the speed of USB 2 for now. They are working on that to fix it. The gigabit Ethernet works at 100 megabits instead of gigabits. They are also working on that. So these things are all the same on all H6 boards in Linux. So one great thing this board has is you can use an eMMC module. So I love these eMMC modules. It's the same as the old Android or for the Rock64 or the Rock Pi 4B. So I can keep using my modules with new boards, and that is great. I will compare it with the Orange Pi 3. It does perform the same, but they have got a few differences. And I will also compare it with the Rock64, also made by Pine64. The software is better on the Pine H64 for now than on the Orange Pi 3. So that is great. I will again use Armbian for it. I have built it myself, but you can already download a nightly version of it. So here we go! So let's start with the specs. I didn't find any good pictures of the Model B, so I had to make one myself. So let's start at the top and go clockwise. So first we see the 40-pin GPIO header, then one port of USB 3. So this just works at USB 2 for now. Then we see two USB 2 ports. Then the gigabit Ethernet port. This also works only at 100 megabits for now. This will be fixed soon. Then we see the 3.5 mm audio jack. This also doesn't work yet. Then the UART pins. Then the HDMI. This is HDMI 2.0, so up to 4K. Then we see a 3-pin SPDIF connector. Next to that is the barrel jack plug. Then we see the infrared receiver and the battery connector. Next to it is the eMMC module connector. And underneath it is the SD card reader. Then we have got two buttons, one for reset and one for power. Above that is the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth chip. Then we have got the SoC. So this is an Allwinner H6 quad-core at 1.8 GHz. And with a dual-core Mali T722 GPU. And as last, there are the RAM chips. So my board has got 4 GB of RAM, but only 3 GB is usable by the system. This is a bit a pity. So the H6 doesn't support 4 GB, only up to 3 GB, but they don't make any 3 GB RAM chips. Here the differences with the Orange Pi 3. So the Pine H64 only has got 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi versus the 5 GHz Wi-Fi of the Orange Pi. The Pine H64 can have up to 3 GB of RAM, while the Orange Pi can only have up to 2 GB of RAM. The Pine H64 only has got one USB 3 port and two USB 2 ports, while the Orange Pi has got 4 USB 3 ports and one USB 2 ports. The Orange Pi also has got the possibility of an onboard eMMC module, while the eMMC module from the Pine H64 can be removed. The Pine H64 has got a 40-pin GPIO header compatible with the Raspberry Pi 2, while the Orange Pi only has got a 26-pin GPIO header. The Orange Pi also has got the PCI Express port. This doesn't work, so they've removed it from the Pine H64 Model B. Now let's compare the Pine H64 Model B with the Rock64. So both look very much alike, they both have got almost exactly the same layouts, but a few differences are there. So the Pine H64 has got Wi-Fi, while the Rock64 doesn't have got Wi-Fi. The Pine H64 can have up to 3 GB of RAM, while the Rock64 can have up to 4 GB of RAM. So the Pine H64 has got the H6 quad-core at 1.8 GHz, while the Rock64 has got the Rockchip RK3328 at 1.5 GHz. The Rock64 also has got an extra GPIO header of 12 pins. Now the temperatures. So with the heatsink and no fan, the idle temperature is 42 degrees Celsius, and maxed out it goes up to 78 degrees Celsius while it throttles. Then it throttles down to 1.5 or 1.3 GHz. With the heatsink and with the fan at 3.3 volts, it idles at 28 degrees Celsius and maxed out it is 64 degrees Celsius. If you compare that with the OrangePi3, it maxed out to 69 degrees Celsius and it idles at 39 degrees Celsius with a 3.3 volt fan. And without a fan, it throttles up to 83 degrees Celsius and the idle temperature was 55 degrees. So the Pine H64 Model B is a lot more usable, even without a fan, with light loads, this is very usable. But if you use it maxed out, then it is better to clock it a little bit lower. Tony Mac from Armbian has added a frequency of 1.64 GHz, and without a fan this is a lot better. This is faster when you use it maxed out without a fan. This because it doesn't throttle. Also, the power consumption is better for the Pine H64B than the OrangePi3. In idle it uses 0.32 amps and maxed out it is 0.9 amps. Versus the OrangePi, it's a half amp in idle and 1.05 amps maxed out. This is a small difference, but when you use a power bank to power them, then this is very important. The Pine H64 and the OrangePi3 perform exactly the same, and compared to other quad-core SBCs, it does very well. Only the Oldroid C2 can keep up with it with the BMW Blender benchmark, but it beats all the others. Then compared to a 6-core NanoPi M4 or a octa-core Cadas FIM 2, it is of course no match. I've already got my Oldroid N2, so I've already added the scores for that, so it is very impressive. This is just a teaser, more about that in the next video. There are plans to get Cydrus in mainline for kernel 5.2 on the H6. Cydrus is an open source GPU driver, so with this the desktop experience will be great, but we will have to wait for that. If you want to know on what they are working right now, you can check this website. All the information of what works and what is coming and what doesn't work is over here. So now my conclusion for the Pine H64 Model B. It's a better designed board than the OrangePi3. This is because it's their second model with the H6. So in their first model they noticed there were some problems and they fixed those problems for the second model. The software for it is right now better than the OrangePi3 its software. It's a lot more usable right now. Only the onboard sound doesn't work, but you can use an USB audio adapter for that. You can watch YouTube videos in Firefox at 720p or watch video files at 1080p with it. So it is usable. It will take months or even years before everything is fixed, but it is already one of the best quad-core boards there are, certainly for this price. If you compare it to the price of the Tinker board, you could buy two Pine H64 boards with that. So I believe this board will become very good. Allwinner SoCs have never been my favorite. They were always the slowest ones. They lied a lot about the frequency, and the mainline support for Linux was very bad for it. But now all that is changing thanks to the Sungchi community. They write open source software and open source drivers for Allwinner SoCs. So that's it for today. Thank you all for watching. I hope you like my video. Please subscribe to my channel. See you later. Bye.